Leadership is the capacity to translate vision into reality. A very warm good evening to honorable guests, dignitaries on and off the dais, and all the student managers present here. I, Khushbu Kakde, student manager of Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, feel honored and privileged to introduce our guest speaker, Mr. Vinod Bidwaik, sir, Director HR at DSM India Pvt. Ltd. He is a microbiology graduate, has done masters in personal management from Pune University, diploma in production management, strategic intervention programs from Strategy Academy, and strategic HRM management from IIM Ahmedabad. Sir is a seasoned HR professional with more than 18 years of experience in human resource and with 11 years of leadership experience in big multinational industries, namely manufacturing, media, automobile and life science, and material science companies. He has authored Marathi book named College to Corporate and English book named Password to Enrich Life. Sir previously worked with Mahindra and Mahindra as a head HR and IR, Semprit Group as a HR head, and Sakal Group Media Group as a Chief Manager Corporate HR. Sir has expertise working on greenfield projects and establishing human resource function. He is currently working with DSM India Pvt. Ltd. as a Director HR and is also part of India Management Team of DSM India. He is on Advisory Council of World HRM Congress and World Leadership Congress. Sir implemented various HR practices, OD interventions in his organization. During his tenure with Semprit, the company was awarded for Best Innovative HR Practices during 2002 by NIPM. He is a life member of Bombay Management Association, NIPM and NHRD. Now, I would like to invite Mr. Vinod sir to enlighten student manager and share his immense knowledge with us. The podium is all yours. Thank you.
Good afternoon. So I think my job is difficult. You had just had a lunch? Yeah? So I will try to keep you wake up with some interesting stories. Yes, no? Okay. First, I express my sincere thanks for inviting me here. Professor Das took a lot of efforts to pitch me in here. And student, specifically Neha, for bringing me here. Thanks a lot. And Balaji Society, Professor Bala. I think, I actually see myself sitting among you. I also went through the similar situation a few years back. Very innocent faces, right? Something thinking about the future, what the future will be, right? Then where the placement will be or not will be, what will be the job profile, invested 2 years, will I get enough ROI, what my investment is done in terms of years, hours, and I heard that you don't have any holidays. So that is too, kitna bojh daloge bachcho ke upar. But this is the life. I think society is taking efforts on you to groom you to so that you face the very scary world, difficult world, I will say, corporate world. So always it is said that how the corporate world is very stressed but well dressed. Yeah. The people in the corporate world are very stressed, but always well-dressed, like me. And it starts from you also, blazers, saris, well-dressed. So you are prepared to conquer the world. Yes, no? So I am going to cover these aspects. What is the future of job? What are the challenges? What are the expectations from management institutes, from the corporate world? And how the corporate world and student can bridge that gap? So I'm going to spend next 45 minutes, 1 hour, on the topic, college to corporate. I also wrote the book, but it's mainly on college to corporate and the role of management institutes to make students corporate ready. Fair enough? Make sense? So, but fundamental question is, we may know this. So every knowledge is available today. I always say that we have a lot of GK. What is GK? It is not general knowledge. It is Google knowledge. On a fingertip, you have knowledge available. So you just get the, you ping the name, you get the information about that. So Google knowledge. A lot of information is available. Don't you? So there's a lot of information available nowadays. And this information, what to do this information? A lot of management concept, business models, strategy, tactical planning, and perhaps you may not need to come to college to learn this. So everything is available on the internet. But then what is needed today? The question is, how to convert this knowledge, how to convert this information into knowledge, and convert this knowledge into the wisdom. So would you like to convert this knowledge into wisdom? But before that, would you like to convert this information into the knowledge? This is a, you know, knowledge in knowledge management, this is a stages, different stages. You have information. You will learn a lot of information. Big data, what is big data? Big data is the information. Now, what is the use of big data? And does it make sense? So it doesn't mean that all these trends are happening is making our life scary. So some speakers or some management consultant or some managers or even sometimes professors make or put the panic button that industry is changing. Not necessary. There is a big data. There is digitization, automation. This is changing our life. But what the effect or consequences of this have on us? That is more important. And next few hours, we would like to, you know, go through this. What are the skill set? Because all these are English. Yes, no. Because big data, everything, digitization, automation, blah, 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 are English. But how to use this and what to learn from this is more important things. So my first suggestion would be just forget everything. I am not going to speak more on big data. I am just covering few points what you need to do to sustain in the corporate world. Yes? Another thing, the corporate world is not too scary, frankly speaking. I survived almost 15 years, 16 years. So it's not scary. It's not the case that, you know, always it is still, it's a ruthless world. Corporate world is very ruthless. There are a lot of problems. Do or die. Frankly speaking, it is not the case. If you are good talent, you are performing well, then it is good world. You can literally enjoy your life in corporate world. So it's not a scary. So take out that notion from your mind that, you know, it's scary, it's very difficult to survive in the corporate world. If actually you are focused, you can do much in the corporate world. Fair enough? But still life is not simple. Is your life simple? You have to come at the college, wake up early in the morning, do the exercise, no holidays, eat food which is not cooked by your mother. Yeah. So your life is not simple. It is complex. Lot of challenges. You are dry. Perhaps you are staying nearby, but I travel here for almost it's 1 hour journey. I go in the office, it takes 1 hour to be in the office. So we have a lot of challenges in our personal life, right? And how the business can be simple. Business, of course, is not simple. I am covering the hookah, but in a different perspective. You already know this, but literally what hookah means to you. Somebody may say that is a vulnerability. Are you vulnerable? I will say be vulnerable. So it is not a vulnerability, world is. I am asking you, I am challenging you to be vulnerable. What is vulnerability? You heard this hookah word, but what is a vulnerability? Any take? Only one, huh? Who will answer? What is vulnerability? You listen this, huh? Hookah yesterday, today. What is vulnerability? Vulnerability, rapid change. But vulnerability is also the challenges. So how you give the opportunity to others to challenge yourself. That's why we always say the hookah is not in terms of the businesses, but hookah is also in our personal life. How challenging, how the space opportunity I give to the people to challenge myself. That is a vulnerability. How I am volatile to the change. So am I just going in a comfort zone or am I working and making my life more volatile? So it's not only, and that's the your institute is doing this. They are stretching yourself. They are stretching yourself. They are pushing from your comfort zone. So that is volatility. And ambiguity, of course, will be there. So we learn about hookah yesterday, today, but the challenge is more than that. So businesses are complex. There are a lot of challenges. But in the business, it's not only a hookah. It's not only ambiguity, vulnerability, complexity. Sometimes businesses may be very simple, just sell. And it's up to the business owner sometimes or a business stakeholders what they expect. Sometimes they expect a simple thing. You have a value proposition, you have a product. There are monopoly products. Now what may be the complexity of Uber? Do you think that there is a complexity? Or what may be the complexity of Facebook? Their complexity may be like they created two robots and they started conversing in their own language. Have you heard this news? And they stopped that. But is it really a complexity? Has this stopped their earning revenues? Perhaps no. So sometimes you have to think about the business complexity. Really is a complex or can you make it more simple? And that's why you are the managers and the people in the organization who have to work on the processes, make it more simple. The vulnerability, complexity, ambiguity, who made this? We made this, yes, no. People make this. If there are simple processes, if we have the processes, we make a simple. We know the customer satisfaction. We know the consumer behavior. If we know that, why we are making it so complex? So your job is not only to just listen this word that is a hookah, 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 and speak about hookah, but understand what is your contribution to make it more life more simple to the businesses. Of course, there are a lot of challenges, a lot of issues happening around, but we need to think. And this definitely needs a different skills. So to do this all, so you want to be convergent with the hookah, you have to do all these things. So I will ask you the question, what are the different skills required? 1, 2, 3. What are the different skills required to manage this all stuff? You can help her. What are the different skills required to face these challenges and make the world more simpler or the businesses? That's why you are taught in the colleges. Yes, no? Technical skills. Analytical skills. Innovation, communication, all this blah, 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 blah. All these soft skills, yes? Exactly. But then it is more than that. It's what it says, how you excel improving your knowledge, skill, and attitude. So So it's knowledge. Of course, you have the knowledge. You spoke about technical skills. Skills, you spoke about how to do that. And main thing is attitude. That's why we say the KSA. But the question, and I would like to challenge yourself here, how to respond to the hookah world. It's not just taking it, but how to responding to that. And it is not reactively, but proactively how to respond. Perhaps next, after 2 years, or maybe the student who are in second year may face placement. And perhaps the world may be different that time. The expectation from corporate may be different. You may join, you get the job, but then what is after 6 months? Okay. So retention by the companies, or retention, your retention by the companies. How you retain to stay there, or how company retain you to be their employee. That challenge starts after 6 months. So that is, I am saying, there's a response. How do you respond to hookah world? And that I will say, how you are agile. What is agility? Flexibility. Anything else? I think agility is more than flexibility. Adaptability. I say the agility is doing things rightly at first time. So agility is, yes, right. Dictionary meaning is flexibility, whatsoever, you know, synonymous terms are there. But according to me, agility is if you are put in unknown condition, how you respond to unknown condition. So for example, you are a manager working here, right, in one function. You are put in another function or in a project. Will you do the same thing in right way? First time right. That is the agility. And always to focus this, what are the skill set you have? Now, future of work and new capabilities required, you know this. And these are the change drivers. So we already discussed about that. There is automation. Machines are working. So chatbot, robotics, all these stuff. So these are the different drivers in change. Conceptual word. So word is very conceptual. Nobody will give you the job description in writing. If job description is given, perhaps when you join the company, nobody will, you know, expect you to just stick in the job description. So there are so many things which is beyond the job descriptions. How you will respond to that? So there's a conceptual word. For example, if the person joined in the market, in a marketing, is that you have to do a marketing job. So market segmentation. Or value proposition for the market, or the product, as per the X, Y, Z theory, whatsoever, Kotler or something else. Right. Now the thing is, how you conceptualize that? Because the salesperson going in the market, he will sell the product, but it is not from you, it is not expected. Will it expect only selling the product? Yes, no. They will expect something different from you. It's not only a product selling. It's how you build account for one product on a longer term. And that is the conceptualizing thing. So first thing is how you conceptualize things is more important. And world is expecting, all this big data and automation is expecting more, is conceptualizing things. So once you join any company, you start contributing individually, right? So you are a sales manager, you are a sales executive, you start contributing. Then over a period of time, 1 year, after 1 year, 2 years, you are expected to work differently. So it is not just individual contributor. You start leading a team. And when you are leading a team, it is not just, you know, our regular connotation like managing a team or handling a team, something like that. Here, guiding the team on conceptual level. So if somebody asks that, what is the innovation you would like to do to improve your NPS score? What is NPS? Net Promoter Scores, you know. So What are the innovations you are going to do? You don't need, you need to work on this concept. Yes, no. So how you are going to do that? So this, all trends are changing. There are almost 40% in banking, if you are joining in banking company, there are 40% loans are approved by robots. Yeah? Yes, no. Who approve the loans in banks? Who approves the loan in banks? Branch manager doesn't approve the loans. Credit manager. Now let me give you the example. In ICICI and HDFC, anybody work in these two companies? So branch manager decides and credit manager decides the norms of to whom the loan should be given. So he conceptualizes things. But once it is done and it is submitted to the machine, so computer, and if it is as per the norms, this is approved by the robots, bots. Another example I would like to give about the bots. Have you subscribed for Tata Sky or something like that? Okay. When you have any issues with Tata Sky, you go on their website and you start chatting. Or policybazaar.com, you go and chatting, and then you enter a chat room and you get a response. Some Ankita or some Ganesh or somebody using. Most probably, in 60% cases, do you think that they are human being? Yes, no? So they are bots. Chatbots, what we say. Now tell me, who will design the chatbots? Or who will design their framework? How the response should be to the customer? And if this communication goes wrong to the customer, what will be the consequence to the company product? So you have to manage that, yes? I am speaking that a conceptual level. So that conceptual thinking needs to be done, how you are devising the framework. So definitely to do this, you need a employability skills and all this stuff you know. You know all this. You need a good communication skill, confidence, decision-making skills, analytical skills, you already told. But more than this, you need something extra. So what is an extra? You always something, there always are an ad. You know, you see on a television, on a toothpaste, there is 10% extra. You always need extra, yes? But companies are also expecting something extra from you people. So what is that extra? Any idea? No? So these are the new extra capabilities, needs for new millennials. This is the expectations. That is sense making. One of the capabilities is sense making. Social intelligence. Novel and adaptive thinking. Cross-cultural competency. Computational thinking. And new media literacy. New word or another English word? Yes, no? Now tell me, what is sense making? Don't read there what is written. What is sense making? Sense making. Can you give me the example of sense making? I was told that you score a lot in CET. So I know that you have a lot of intellect present in this room. Almost 900 students sitting here. So you have a lot of intellect here. So definitely you can interpret what the sense making is. Can you give me one of the example of sense making? Yes. He's saying sense making is reading between the lines, interpreting something, and building on that next. Yes. Any contradictory opinion about this or supportive, would like to something? Communicating the fact. So I think sense making, let me give the example. Facebook started two robots. So they started artificial intelligence. So their two robots started communicating with each other in different language. And it went worst. So Facebook had to stop this, initiative. So they closed this initiative. Now here, the person behind this artificial intelligence who is working on that, perhaps has the major role of sense making, that what the communication language should be and why this started. So perhaps there may be some coding which went wrong, and you are right that reading between the line, or in a corporate world, if your manager is telling something, so he may tell something, you X thing, but how you are actually understanding and interpreting the things and taking forward and building your conceptual model or your learning, all your product design based on that is the sense making. Do you think that it makes sense? Social intelligence, what does it mean? So we have a couple of types of intelligence. Famous intelligence is IQ, your intellect. You have UQ, emotional intelligence. Then your cultural quotient, right? So cultural intelligence and your social intelligence. So social intelligence is not meaning that you are networking, speaking with the people, sitting in the room, having breakfast or dinner with the networks. In the organization, there are different groups. So you have different groups of people working in the organization. So there are marketing groups, technology group, research group, and these groups are social groups. So they have different mindset, they have different priorities. The people working there have their different agendas. They want to be successful. Now in social intelligence, how you understand the dimensions of social relationship? Right? You may be friend, but you can't be a friendly sometimes. So always it is said in the corporate world that you can be a friend, you can be friendly with the people, but you can't be a friend of the person. So how you understand who is your friend and to whom you should be a friendly? Who is going to support you or who is not supporting you? So that is understanding that context and taking help of your cultural intelligence and all this stuff. Of course, adaptive thinking, your cross-cultural competences. So in India itself is a cross-cultural world. So you are coming from north, south, west, east. And then there are different personalities. How you deal, how you understand the people. And most important thing is new media literacy. In which languages communicate to the people? I have seen most of the times to the HR people, the resumes comes. And in the resume, resumes are forwarded and it just written as a PFA. Attach the resume and PFA. Now what the action will take, the recruiter will take. Perhaps that resume may go directly in the junk box, will not be accepted. But there may be other communication, like normally in emails we write, one of my colleagues, she newly joined in the team, she wrote cause in the email. The language of millennials is changing, right? So we use small words, but it's going to work in corporate. Are your customers are that mature to understand that? Yes, no. So if you are going, you join in banking industry, you are a BCom, MBA graduate, join in SDFC or ICICI, and SDFC ask you to call the people and go for sale your their insurance policies. And you have to do that job. Not necessary that after MBA you will go and sit in a conference rooms or air conditioned offices. Most of the times, first 6 months, you have to go on a ground and work there when I spoke somebody in the morning, that in FMCG or insurance or banking industries, literally you have to sell policies sometimes, right? And you have heavy targets. Now there, how you will do this? Yeah? How you will do this? How you will understand the customer? Are your customer that mature to understand your communication language? How you will communicate? Will you communicate in your SMS language or your WhatsApp language? Yeah, so that, but this is happening. So how you do that? And sometimes your customer may be millennials. They don't want to listen more story, just simple 2 words, tell me the benefit. So you have to tune accordingly. So this all stuff is required to understand that aspects. These are certain capabilities. What is this? What is design mindset? Virtual collaboration, cognitive load management, and transdisciplinarity. If there are 4 candidates for the job of sales manager from campus, everybody is going to tell that what is your strength? You speak good English, you have good communication skill, you have good leadership skills. Everybody will say that. Yes, no. All students sitting in room in this room have good communication skills. That's why you are shortlisted here. Good leadership skills. Then what is the differentiator? Why there is only one position from among 900 students, only one or two will be shortlisted on specific company by Google or Facebook if they come? What is that differentiator? And that is differentiator is your design mindset. So design mindset, there is written that ability to represent and develop task and work processes for desired outcome, but it is not an end. How you actually design the processes which has a desired result. So today's, what are the your decisions, today's decisions, which will have the consequences of tomorrow. So if you are thinking something, that will have the consequences of something else. So that is a design mindset which is required. So always think that apart from this employability skill, what are that unique selling point which you have, because you are going to market yourself to the corporate. What are that design mindset skills, extra skills you have? And I explain you some skills you have here that is more important to work upon. Now, the question always is how, right? The question is always how. And here the expectation mainly is, and my suggestion would be, and I will give some examples, focusing more on summer internship. You may have only one summer internship, right? My suggestion would be just as far as possible, work a lot of assignments. I will give the example, and there were 3 students came to us. These 3 students wanted to the project in sales. Now there was internal guide and external guide, so their guide in the college told that you do something on, you know, whatsoever market and in that. Our requirement was different. So my salesperson, my segment manager told them that you have to do the project identifying the product in water management equipment, so AquaGuard and similar product. Identify that component, check this, how many components are made of metal, how many made of plastics, how many made of different components, and who supply that product to the AquaGuard and these companies, who are the customers, do the value proposition, and where our product goes. Now this is a big project, right? Out of this 3 student, 1 student back out. He said, itna karna padega, sir. Hame to sirf certificate ka expectations tha. 2 students started working on that, and they literally actually spent 2 months, 1 month was extended, so 3 months. They visited all industries. They traveled across the region. They spoke. They did a cold calling. Most of the component manufacturers were not willing to respond, because nobody will tell, what's going on that. Finally, somehow, they did the project. They collected a lot of data. They collected a lot of things. They make a beautiful presentation to us. And we told him that, do one thing. Send this presentation, masking all the confidential information, to the component manufacturers, to whom you, who you supported you. They send this, and believe me, before placement, these two students were shortlisted by Pentair. You know Pentair? Pentair is a water management company based at Goa as a sales manager. It's a handsome package. Now, how they did this? What they did in this process? In this process, they work on a conceptual thinking. They design something differently. Of course, there was an internal coach who supported them. They work on a lot many things like, what are the consequences, what are the product value proposition. They actually work on their soft skills also, because they have to do a lot of cold calling, understanding the purchase people, in the sales people in the organization. So they connect, they actually connected with the relationship. And they build a relationship in different organizations. This happened in something 2 years back. Now I came to know that one of the company, one of the person left to another company, and where he joined? He joined the person to whom he approached earlier for the component, specification, and during the project. Now mind well, that person remember this project guy, that yes, he called me sometimes, he sent a presentation, perhaps this person may be good. That's how the talents are identified by the organization. And if the time is got, that are place. So that's how the networking works. Assignments. How many assignments can do? Can you, if I ask you that I would like to do something in my organization, how many will be willing to work on assignment? Free of cost. Some hands going down, yeah? But that is good sign. As far as possible, work lot many assignments. Why I'm saying this, in top business schools, your is also top business, almost 60 assignments in 2 years. That may be small assignments, that may be surveys in the organization, that may be implementing of some projects. Networking. What is your network with your seniors? You may have your alumni group. Yeah. Network, because they may be the media to support you in your career. Now, one thing I would like to say, keep yourself updated. Most of the time during the interview, we ask the question that what do you read? So student give the answer that they read newspapers. And once asked that which newspaper you read, they say Times of India, okay. Then ask, have you read today's newspaper? So tell me the news of today. What is the prominent news related to you? So they say that, sir, we could not read today's newspaper. Then if you ask them that, okay, tell me what is the happening around industry yesterday? Is there any news yesterday? They say, sir, for last few days we are very stuck up. There are so many events happening. There are, so we could not sleep properly, so we could not read newspapers. Once I asked one student, what do you read? So he said, I read books. Which book you read? Ignited Mind, yeah? Something, Dr. Abdul Kalam's book. When you read this? So when I was in 12th. Books are really good friends. Huh? They are good mentors, either apart from academics book. I'm not saying academics books. Not academics book. Books on certain aspects. So it can be, books can be anything. There are good books like, one book I read is How to Think Critically, Ralph Dobelli. There are different errors human being makes, and that is also related to design thinking. We make almost 100 errors in our life. What is that errors? For example, if I am assessing the performance of the person, I will consider his past performance for next. So ideally, I should rate him based on his whole year performance. But normally the managers, what they do? What's happened in next 1 month? If the person did good, they will rate him good. If person did bad, they will rate him bad. That is called as a recency error. So the person may do a lot of things in a year, but at the end of the year, what's happening, we tend to, you know, recollect the recent things. So there are 100 types of errors, stereotyping and all these stuff. So we need to decide how to avoid these errors. And that is a part of design thinking. So the reading is important. So what you read is more important. So it's not only newspaper. So that's why I'm saying that keep always updating yourself. And in summary, if you are agile, so there are these types of different type of agilities, I will say. How you are self-awareness? So are you self-aware? Your mental agility, your people agility, change agility, and result agility. So how you are self-aware? Do you know your strength, weaknesses? Do you know what is the level of your design thinking or social intelligence or other this stuff? Do you know how you manage different people in difficult situations? What is your mental agility? Can you be, if somebody coming directly in front of you all of a sudden in stressful situation, how you'll respond to that? Your mental agility, result oriented, and how you take the change. I will not say don't, you know, employability, all this stuff is, if you do these things, if you learn all this aspect, the possibility is that you will become the one normally in your career. What's happened normally in the day? We get the job, right, where we are good at. Sometimes that doesn't pay well. But the challenge always is you get a job, what you are good at, what pays well, and what you love. So you love the job, you have the passion into that, you are good at that, like Jakir Hussain, and it is also pays well. That is bingo. But really it happens. Will it happen? The possibility is that it may happen because then you have a learning agility. Because then you start liking that. That is more important. So summary here is that perhaps for a few years you may not like the job, but it may pay well. So you also have to decide your priority. And my submission always is there that find a purpose. What is your purpose? What is the purpose of the organization? What is the purpose of the role? And if you can all align this purpose, then only it's possible that perhaps you can make your career and build your career which you like. This is from my side. I think if you have any questions, you can ask me. You can get more information about this agility and, you know, from these books. These are available Flipkart and Book Ganga and all these stops. So thanks. Questions?
Hello. Hello. Yes, sir. My name is Rahul. And actually, everyone is making a big issue of VUCA, VUCA, VUCA. And since morning one day, I was listening about the VUCA and all. So do you think that before this term VUCA came into picture, world was never been certain. It was always been uncertain, always been volatile. So why corporate is making a big issue of VUCA right now? So I am unable to understand it. So can you please?
Okay. So Rahul asked that why we are crazy about VUCA. Why? Because for so many years there were uncertainty, business companies were doing the businesses. I will say that businesses were always there. There is always uncertainty in the business. Before license Raj, so Indira Gandhi, there were something, you know. So Indira Gandhi was the pioneer to move this license Raj. But earlier it was a license. So you had given the license for manufacturing something. So it was only seller, buyer's market, seller's market. Today is buyer's market. Now why I am saying VUCA, you see, first world revolution, how many years it took? For first industry revolution. How many years took? Almost 40s. Then second, 20 years, 30 years. Then it came third, computer revolution. How many years took? 10 years. Now there were pagers. How many years these pagers disappeared? Within 6 months or 1 year. So you see from, and I will give the example of telecommunication. Landlines. In communication, we had a landlines for so many years in your homes. But then to landline, computer to laptop, and laptop to tablet, or pager to mobile, how many years it happened? Within 2 years. So why we should be concerned about VUCA? Because the changes are happening too fast, which were not earlier. You don't know the company you are joining will be there tomorrow or not. Somebody may be there who may acquire that company, or somebody, your owner may sell that company to somebody else. So management may change. And the, as management change, the strategy may change. So we need not to be worried about VUCA word, frankly speaking. But we should align to the complexity so that we respond properly. So you are well prepared to respond. So my opinion is that yes, there is a VUCA. Earlier it was also the VUCA. But now speed has been changed. So that we need to care of, taken care of. May I answer your question? Yeah.
Sir, my question is, can a biased mindset of a single person leads to the disruption of organization culture?
Sorry?
Can a biased mindset of a single person leads to the disruption of organization culture? If you take example of recently, Demore software engineer has been sacked from Google. Because he had given biased opinion
about gender.
Woman,
yeah.
So, what's your take on that?
Yes or no? It depends upon the organizational culture, what the management has built in the organization. Now, biased opinion is one of the thing, and that that's why the companies are nowadays focusing on inclusion and diversity. What is inclusion? Opinion may be biased. But we should listen that person and understand why he is biased. Because he may have certain experiences. And based on experiences, he is making his own opinion. Now it is up to the management or the seniors to take a call how to respond to that. Yeah. So not necessarily always it's a disruptive, but it is definitely is problematic, is may create a problems in the organization. So that is a senior management responsibility to take care of. Yeah?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
As we are known that recently Facebook shut down two artificial intelligence systems which were talking with them, having communication with them with the unknown language. So what is the possibility that any artificial intelligence system will have a conspiracy against humanity? Yeah. And again, as we are knowing that RPA, that is robot application programming, is replacing near about 30-40% of jobs in banks. Of humanity. So
what is artificial intelligence? Does it mean that they will replace the human brain? No. Artificial is just combination of some statement. So there is one statement, what is the response to that? So the programming is done that, for example, there is an artificial intelligence panel, you have a board. You know, Google is working on that. You have a board for the student. And you throw the question. And that will give the answer. So there is statement, and there is response to the statement. That is artificial intelligence. So it is not a rocket science. It may go wrong. But it is coding and programming is important. So artificial intelligence is not the final. I don't think that artificial intelligence statement, who is feeding or who is programming, are human being. Right? So it is not always perfect. So according to me, I don't think that artificial intelligence will, you know, robots can replace the job, but not artificial intelligence will replace the job. They will be supportive to robots.
And again, sir, Watson, robot of IBM, it is having 62% correct legal answers or legal decisions as compared to humans. So again, it's, and they are thinking to use it as a commercial, so for commercial purpose. So again, it seems that law is also going with artificial intelligence.
But you see, because human brain is always based on memory. So for example, take an example of legal, you know, I need to read the legal document. Okay, now there are two possibilities. Robo read the legal document or human read the legal document. Now human can make errors. So according to what the feed in the mindset of the human being, he will read and interpret the language. Robo reads the draft of the legal, you know, but he will read what is feed. So if section 23 says something, he will be correct. He will narrate that section 3 correctly. The possibility is that human being will not narrate that section 23 correctly, because there is a programming and data is fed accordingly. And that is not one time. That is repeatedly and continuously updated. Yes. So somebody is there who is updating the data on that. In Facebook case, it happened because there was a coding and decoding problem. Something went wrong technically, not, you know, what you say as a language of that. So it technically went, that's why they started communicating. Sometimes, you know, even a machine, you start in a manufacturing also. If your assembly line, sometimes assembly line is automated, the size of the torque, what is put, not necessarily the right way. So it may go wrong, but important is what you are feeding to the robot is important. So I think robots will have the accuracy, but thinking power still will be with the human beings. And that is also the repetitive nature. So if, for example, if there is a journalist and who is writing a news, what he will do? He will collect the data and he will write a news. So in news, the data and accuracy will be absolute. However, human nature may put his own opinion to that. Yeah?
Good evening to one and all. I, Anjali Taide, student manager of Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, feel privileged to get this opportunity to thank you. I would like to express my high regards to our guest, Mr. Vinod Bidwaik, sir, for lifting our vision to a high site. Thank you, sir, for sparing your valuable time to guide us for a successful career and adding a new dimensions to our career. That was undoubtedly an encouraging session and an inspiring dose for us, and we all are immensely benefited by your inspiring address. Especially, like sir mentioned, life is not simple and also business, and if you're agile, you'll get what you wish. Sir also showed us a way to prepare, how to prepare for corporate world and stay there for long. I would also wish to manifest my respect to our beloved Bala sir for providing us the opportunity to listen to such an eminent and motivating personality and providing us a stimulating and learning environment. Thank you.